Welcome students to the video solutions of pre-NEET mock test number 2 for chemistry. Students, as we have already discussed in the last mock test, that now onwards the entire paper of chemistry will be divided into two sections, section A and section B. Section A has 35 questions and section B has 15 questions. In section A, we have to attempt all the questions. In section B, out of 15 questions, we have to attempt only 10 questions. So, starting with section A, let's start the video solutions of section A. Let's read our first question, students, which is question number 51. For positive deviation from Raoult's law, which among the given relations is incorrect? Student, I'm taking two solvents A and B, two volatile solvents A and B. When the force of attraction between A, B are weaker than those exist between AA and BB, then that solution will show positive deviation from Raoult's law. And when the force of attraction between A, B are stronger than those exist between AA and BB, then that solution will show negative deviation from Raoult's law. Here we have to answer for positive deviation. So, students, for positive deviation, here I'm writing for positive deviation delta H mixing is greater than 0, delta V mixing is greater than 0, delta S mixing is greater than 0 for both ideal as well as non-ideal solution. Also, delta G mixing is less than 0 for both ideal as well as non-ideal solution. That means the incorrect relation among the following is given in option number 1. So the correct answer is option number 1. Students, let's move to the next question, which is question number 52. Let's read it. Consider the following statements. Students, in this question we are given with 3 statements and we have to identify the correct statements among them. So let's read the first statement. Mixture of CO and N2 is called synthesis gas. Student, this is an incorrect statement, as we know that mixture of CO and N2 is known as a producer gas. And synthesis gas is a mixture of CO and H2. Moving to the next statement. CO reduces both Fe2O3 and ZnO to their respective metals. Student, this is a correct statement, as CO is a good reducing agent. It reduces Fe2O3 and ZnO into their respective metals. I'm writing the reaction. Fe2O3 solid plus 3CO gas on heating gives 2Fe solid plus 3CO2 gas. And let's talk about ZnO. Zinc oxide solid plus CO gaseous heat gives Zn solid plus CO2 gaseous. Moving to the next statement, students. CO is a pi acid ligand. Student, this is a correct statement, as CO is a sigma donor and a pi acceptor. It accepts electron density to the pi antibonding molecular orbital, that is pi star molecular orbital, from filled d orbitals of the metal. Hence, it is called as pi acid ligand. That means the correct statements are B and C. And we can see the correct answer is option number 2. So here I'm writing correct answer is option number 2. Moving to the next question, students, which is question number 53. Let's read it. Mass of zinc deposited at cathode by passing a current of 3.86 ampere for 100 minutes in molten zinc chloride is, we are given with the atomic mass of zinc, which is 65.4 units. Student, first of all, we'll be calculating the number of Faradays passed in the cell. So here I'm writing number of Faradays passed, which is equals to current multiplied by time upon 96500, that is the value of 1 Faraday. So current is 3.86. The time we are given in minutes, so we have to convert this into seconds, so multiplied by 60, divide by 96500, which is equals to 0.24. Student, I have already multiplied this. You people, please avoid using calculator. Initially, it might take more time, but eventually, your time will decrease and your accuracy will increase, definitely. So, student, next, we know that number of Faradays passed is equal to number of equivalents of metal deposited at cathode. So, here we'll be calculating the equivalent weight of zinc, which is equals to its atomic mass, that is 65.4 upon its n factor, which is equals to 2. Now, students, we can calculate the mass of zinc deposited, which is equals to 0.24 multiplied by 65.4 upon 2, which is equals to 7.8 gram. That means the correct answer is option number 4. Here I'm writing answer is option number 4. Moving to the next question, students, which is question number 54. For the reversible reaction, A plus 2B gives 3C, if equilibrium constant is 1 into 10 raised to the power 2 at 27 degrees Celsius, then the value of delta RG naught at the same temperature will be. We are given with the value of R, that is gas constant, which is 2 calorie per Kelvin per mole. Student, first of all, in this question, we are given with the value of equilibrium constant, which is 1 into 10 raised to the power 2. We are given with temperature, which is 27 degrees Celsius. So we have to convert this temperature into Kelvin. So equilibrium constant, that is KC, is equals to 1 into 10 raised to the power 2. Temperature is equals to 27 degrees Celsius, but we have to convert this into Kelvin. So we have to add 273, which is equals to 300 Kelvin. We have to calculate the value of delta RG naught. We know that delta RG naught is equals to minus RT ln K. Let's convert this into log. So minus 2.303 into R into T. Here it will be log base 10 K. Now, student, let's put the value of R, T and K in the equation. We'll get minus 2.303 into R. R is 2, temperature is 300, and log base 10. The value of K is given, that is 1 into 10 raised to the power 2, which is equals to minus 2.303 into 2 into 300 into 2. Since log 1 into 10 to the power 2 is 2. Student, again, I've solved this numerical problem and the value will be minus 2.76 kilocalorie per mole. That means the correct answer is option number 2. Here I'm writing correct answer is option number 2. Moving to the next question, students, which is question number 55. For the reaction, Br2 gaseous gives 2Br gaseous, the correct option is. Student, first of all, this is a decomposition reaction. And since energy is required to break a bond, that means enthalpy change is positive. Now let's talk about entropy. Entropy change is also positive as the number of particles increases after dissociation. That means delta RH is greater than 0. Also, delta RS is greater than 0. That means the correct answer is option number 2. Moving to the next question, students.